We return once again then to the home of British motorsport and the birthplace of the Formula One World Championship. It's race day here at Silverstone and it's time for the British Grand Prix. Straddling the border of Northamptonshire and Buckinghamshire, the 18 corners of Silverstone Circuit form the 3.6-mile beating heart of Formula One. It's been reinvented over the years, with Turn 1 now the fast right-hander of Abbey, but the magic of racing is as strong here as it's ever been. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole, edging out Lando Norris, who'll start from P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Varsandy, Russell, Max Verstappen, and Perez. Ricardo, Fernando Alonso, Joe, and Valtteri Bottas. Magnussen, Gasly, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Tsunoda. Vettel, Mick Schumacher, Lance Stroll, and Alex Albon. Ocon, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into Turn 1, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Unnecessary wear to your transmission. Try to take it easy, or you're going to risk losing it. number of shifts to a minimum, please.
pressure to take a well-earned victory here at the British Grand Prix. Talk to me, Ants. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari.
better for Sandy. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari continue to extend the gap at the top of the table. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport action. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.